become a tradition here at Hendricks, thanks to Karen Greedley. But it is a time of the church here that has gone on for hundreds of years. And it's the time when the church reminded us of all the great saints and the martyrs of the church, those that we read about, we learn about, we study, and we know by name. But it is also a time in the church where we remember those who are nameless, but have probably more meaning to us personally. Those family and friends and mentors and teachers and those who have gone before us who have established and meant so much in our lives. So with that, I invite us to pray. For all the saints who went before us, who have spoken to our hearts and touched us with your fire, we praise you, O God. For all the saints who live beside us, whose weakness and strengths are woven with our home, we praise you, O God. For all the saints who live beyond us, who challenge us to change the world with them, we praise you, O God. For all the saints near and dear to us, family, friends, colleagues, for whom we miss dearly, we praise you, O God. Thank you, God, that you have given us ways and people to help us remember all the saints who have empowered our lives. We pray this in your holy name. Amen.
Thank you so much, Reverend Clark. I want to thank all of you for coming this evening to help us observe this very special day in the life of the college, in the life of the church, in the life of all of us. I'd also like to mention a couple of things about the piece that you just heard. It is actually bitonal, meaning that there are several tonalities, at least two tonalities going on at any given time, which I think was really quite an interesting effect. You may have noticed that the English horn sometimes sounded like it was in a different key from the strings. There were times when the violins sounded like they were in a different key from the cellos and so on and so forth. I think there are lots of ways in which our lives sometimes can be bitonal as well. When we try to reach out in terms of diversity, we have diverse tonalities amongst us, I think, as well. The next work is actually a piece that inspired this entire program this evening. Last year, about this time, I heard Lashina Gordon sing this beautiful aria from Porgy and Bess by George Gershwin. And it occurred to me, the moment she opened her beautiful voice and filled the hall, that next year we need to include this piece on this program. And I think I raised up to her after the performance and said, would you come and sing this for us next year? So I'm really proud and happy to share this beautiful, beautiful piece of music by a beautiful woman who's got a glorious voice with you this evening. Thank you.
Thank you.
it's obviously the glorious romantic grand opera by an African-American composer about one of the great African-American leaders of our country. And I hope that we'll get an opportunity to hear much more of this in the future. It's a really, really beautiful, lovely piece of music and very inspiring. So our next work we're going to do is a piece by a living American composer who happens to be a friend of mine. He retired from the faculty of the Juilliard School and from the Philadelphia Academy of the Arts several years ago. This piece was written in